I got my X5c-1. I've had a couple people ask me about how I set my camera up on this. I do it pretty simple, straightforward. There's lots of ways you can do it. The Flying Tech RC has a good method, and you can find other ones, but I'm just going to show you how I do it, just because I like the portability of it, and I can transfer it from one drone to another drone. So I'll just go over real quick how I hook up my TX02 all-in-one for a FPV flying. Okay. I had some of this packaging foam from a package, and I cut out a little square and I hollowed it out a little bit to fit my camera, and I just put some tape around it, just kind of hold it together. And I just take my little all-in-one camera and just slide it down in there. And that's all there is to it. Now I have the adapter, the 2-pin, small pin adapter that goes to the 2-pin micro LoSi for the standard batteries for the X5. I got a little bit of Velcro on the top of the quad, and I got some on the bottom of my camera piece. And basically I just kind of stick that on there like that. And what I like to do is, I got this thin tape, I guess it's 1/4-inch tape. What I like to do, I put a piece of tape right here. It just kind of brings that foam all together and just kind of holds that tight in there. And then I also go ahead and I put two more pieces on the side. It's probably overkill, but I like it because you can pull it down tight and it brings the angle of the camera back a little bit. Too long, but all right. And that's basically how I hold my camera on there. Now, I'm running pretty much 680 milliamp batteries all the time. I need to get, maybe a lot of people are talking about those 750s, so I might look into that. But what I power this thing with is another battery. This is a 300 milliamp battery. And I just kind of stick it onto the Velcro. I've got some more Velcro on the bottom of the battery door. And I usually stick it on there. And then most of the times, just in case, I don't want the battery coming off, I'll just go ahead and put another piece of tape there just to hold it on. Then plug in my battery to my TX, and I got power. Now, one thing you're going to have to remember is, after you're flying, if you use that, when you turn the quad off, just make sure you unplug this, because this is always going to have power to it. I forgot a couple times, but it didn't take me long to learn that. Just because the quad's off doesn't mean this battery's not giving your camera power. And then I normally take my cable and just kind of stick it under a piece of tape to keep it from moving around. And that's it. That's all I do. Then I'm ready to go FPV flying. And I'm telling you, I've just been flying FPV not very long, but flying FPV with this X5 is very, very fun. And I'm using the X8 transmitter. This is the way to go. A lot more range. Yeah, this is a blast. I have a couple videos on my channel flying the X5 with this transmitter, and then I think I might have one with the old transmitter. But I just got done doing a night flight with this out in the parking lot, and it was pretty fun too. And this little camera actually did better than I thought it would. So that's my setup, and this is what I used when I was flying in the parking lot. So let's take a look at that. All right, thanks for tuning in. Appreciate it.